Hiya sea fans and welcome back. In this video, we're going to be looking at why you should never be afraid to call a dive. Whether you're a newly qualified diver or a hardened veteran, you should never feel you have to do a dive that you don't want to. But sometimes peer pressure can make it hard to just say no, even though that is exactly what you should do. I'll tell you a useful rule of thumb that I have to avoid any situations like that. For those here for the first time, my name's Mark, I'm the Editor-in-Chief of the Scuba Diver media brand, and welcome to the Scuba Diver YouTube channel. Remember to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any future videos, and if you ring that bell, you'll get notification of our latest releases. Don't forget to check out below how you can get a free digital subscription to any of our magazines. That's Scuba Diver UK, Scuba Diver Australia and New Zealand, and Scuba Diver Destinations, which is our US and Canada edition. And if you want to get your hands on a print version, we have a special subscription deal just for our YouTube followers. Now, let's dive into the video. I have a little saying. It is better to be on the boat or shore wishing you were on a dive than being on a dive and wishing you were on the boat or the shore. We've all had those days where something just doesn't feel right. You might not be able to put your finger on it. It's just there niggling away in the back of your mind. And this is when we absolutely have to be able to say, I am not doing this dive. However, far too often people feel unable to do this for a variety of reasons. I started my path into diving via my uncle and his buddies. Many of them were commercial divers and all of them were veteran North Sea wreck divers. However, rather than feel overawed or intimidated by their collective knowledge, years of experience or number of dives, I instantly felt welcome and safe in their company. They took my diving through quite a steep learning curve, but it was all done at my own pace and with no outside pressure. The major thing which took any weight off my shoulders was that right from day one, their rule of thumb was that any diver could call off a dive at any time, and crucially, not have to give a reason or explain why. And I have kept this rule at the core of my diving ever since. These were proper, hardcore, roughy-tufty divers, and it would have been quite easy to succumb to peer pressure and feel that I had to do the planned dives to not let them down. But having had that rule instilled in me from an early age has really helped me down the line. And I have never felt pressured into doing any dive I didn't want to do. Even to this day, after close to 40 years of diving, if I don't want to do a dive, I won't. Remember, you don't have anything to prove to anyone. Likewise, I am quick to stress this rule with anyone I'm diving with. I often travel on assignment alone. And while I normally collar an instructor or a dive master to be my buddy and underwater model, on occasion, I just get paired up with another diver that's on board. Many times, these divers have been a bit freaked out because they were concerned that they were going to ruin my dive, cut it short, etc., because they knew I was there working, and so I always aim to put their minds at rest as soon as possible. The best thing with this rule of thumb is that all my dive buddies are made aware of it right from when we first meet. And the not have to give a reason or explain why is a vital part of it. Some people are unwilling to can a dive if they don't feel they can adequately explain a reason why they did it. But as I mentioned before, sometimes you just can't put your finger on it. You just know you don't want to dive. Not having to explain your rationale relieves a lot of the pressure. But equally, if people do want to talk about it afterwards, then I'm always open to that as well. But it is always on their terms. For some people, it is cathartic to get it out there and discussed. It helps them move on from the aborted dive. It's pretty obvious why you don't want to succumb to peer pressure. If you are already on edge before a dive, then you're asking for trouble underwater. If you are teetering on the brink with a heightened level of apprehension before you even hit the water, then if anything does go awry on the dive, you are going to be in a world of hurt. Minor issues, which could be dealt with in a calm and collected manner, can seem insurmountable when you're already overstressed. And this spiralling incident pit can suck you in, with potentially fatal consequences, let's be honest. I think what reinforces how beneficial this rule of thumb regarding calling a dive is that I have seen peer pressure at its worst on dive trips around the world. Now, I could stand here all day talking about appalling stuff I've seen on dive trips, but let's just pull up a couple of examples. I remember being on a boat in the Florida Keys. The young couple was sat very quiet at the back of the boat. She looked worried. The poor chap, frankly, looked downright terrified. I casually went over for a chat and it was blatantly obvious the lad was in no fit state to go in the water for a dive. His wife was raring to go, but you could see that she was worried about her husband. Now, they weren't complete novices. They were PADI Advanced Open Water Divers with a couple of hundred dives. But for whatever reason, he was freaked out on this particular day. Now, the conditions were not exactly benign. There was quite a chop on the surface. There was some current running. But having overheard his dive group leader back at the dock really talking up the forthcoming dive, we were on the wreck of the Dwayne, for those interested, which is a cracking dive. It was my belief that the man had just worked his mind into overload. The dive leader seemed completely oblivious to the man's distressed state and was loudly talking on the boat about strong currents, your mast being blown off, all the usual. All this was doing was stressing the diver out even more. The dive leader only seemed to notice the issue when everyone was getting kitted up. But instead of offering any support or talking quietly to the diver, he instead loudly berated him to the rest of the group, telling him to man up, not be a wimp, and so on. Myself and the dive master that were on board did attempt to step in, but the diver by now was set to go on the dive to not lose face in front of the other divers. Sure enough, they hadn't been below the surface more than a few minutes before him and his wife appeared back at the ladder. They hadn't even got below 10 metres when full-blown panic kicked in, and thankfully, she'd managed to slow his ascent back up the line. We got them back on board, got him de-kitted, sat in the front of the boat wrapped in a towel, got him a drink. He still couldn't explain what was wrong, just that he didn't feel right. We assured him he'd done the correct thing, but you could tell that he was embarrassed and worried about what his buddies would be saying. Sure enough, en route to the next dive site, which was on the shallow reef, there were various comments directed at him by the dive leader and others. Once we were at the reef dive, which was only about 7 or 8 metres deep or so, I sat and chatted to the couple, who seemed visibly more relaxed now we were in calmer conditions. They agreed to go for a dive with me, and we just took our time, let everyone else get off the boat first, and then went off for a nice mooch. We had a nice, relaxed dive, and on returning to the boat, the male diver looked very happy with himself. I told him that he did well to get back on the wagon straight away, but also said they should maybe look for another dive group in the future. One of the very worst types of peer pressure I've witnessed firsthand is the trust me dive. You know what I'm talking about. Divers urging others to join them on a dive that might be beyond their experience or skill level, but who are told it will be fine as they are with them. Perhaps the most shocking example of this was in the Bahamas. We were scheduled to do two different dive sites. A deep swim through, effectively skirting the edge of the entrance to various full-on cave systems for the more experienced on board, and a shallower reef for the remainder of the divers. As we left the dock, I could hear one of the open water divers talking to one of the more experienced divers. He was asking about what the swim through was going to be like. Next minute, I hear the more experienced diver saying how he'd take the more novice with him on the dive and that he'd keep an eye on him. I had a quiet word with the dive master to alert him to the situation that was rapidly developing in front of me, but incredibly, he just shrugged it off, said the guy was his friend and an experienced diver, and that it would be fine for him to take the new diver. Now, my spidey sense was going into overdrive at this point, but there was nothing else really I could do. I did try to talk to the new diver, but he just didn't want to hear. Anyway, long story short, we all went off on the dive and all seemed to be going all right. The open water diver looked nice and comfortable in the water, but all that changed when we hit the swim through at 40 odd metres. He seemed to be on the brink of refusing to go in, but then his buddy gestured for him to follow and shot into the darkness. After a second or two, the diver followed him in. Luckily, they were the first buddy team behind the dive master, because about halfway through that swim through, the diver went into full-blown panic mode. He bolted for the exit and passed the dive master at speed and was well on his way to rocket into the surface if the guide hadn't finned like mad and managed to grab hold of his BCD as he charged past. He was in such a state, he ran out of air at about 30 metres and had to go on to the DM's octopus. And where was the trust me buddy while all this was going along? Still poking around, back in the swim through. In fact, I don't think he was even aware his buddy had shot off in the first place. And the worst thing, when we were back on the boat, the experienced diver never came anywhere near the other diver, who was in a real state of himself and badly shaken. He never took any responsibility for his actions. Ridiculous. Just an add-on to that story, the dive master no longer works there anymore after the owners of the centre learned what had happened. Now this is the crux of the matter. If the proverbial hits the fan while you are on the dive, it's you that's going to be dealing with the consequences, not those who pressured you into going diving in the first place. So only take the plunge on your terms. My advice, if you get peer pressure to do a dive you are not happy about from your dive buddy or your dive group, then I'd suggest you need to look for another buddy or dive centre. Now, have you encountered peer pressure on any of your dive trips? Leave your comments below. And if you have a question, fire away. If we can't answer it, maybe someone in our community will be able to. Remember, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And don't forget, you can grab a free digital magazine subscription in the description below. As always, stay safe. And if you're able to get out and dive, enjoy.